Hey, Dr. Sia with you. So what is citrulline? What does it have to do with energy? This is a good question. I included citrulline in our new adrenal energy mixture. It's not a common ingredient, but it's got a lot of good science behind it. It's a safe and effective thing your body normally does use. I just want to take a minute and explain a bit more about it and give more of an introduction to it. So L-citrulline, also called citrulline malate, this is an amino acid. Now, it's one that's not used in structure. It's not used to build things in the body, but it's used in metabolism. So a great deal of the Krebs cycle pathways that the mitochondria use to generate energy are citrulline dependent. The body does make it. We do get some in the diet, and there's quite a bit of pretty cool science behind it. So where does it come from in the diet? Well, there's some in some foods, but Citrullus lanatus, which is the common watermelon, that's the main dietary source of it. We get a little bit in some other melons. We get some from cucumbers, but really watermelon's the densest source of that. How much is there? Enough to where with a pound of watermelon, you get about 1,000 milligrams of citrulline. And as we'll see, that can be useful. Now, the cool thing about watermelon is a pound of it might sound like a lot, but it really isn't. It's easy to eat a pound of watermelon. I'm just thinking back on, you know, in the summertime, one of my favorite things is I'll keep cubed watermelon, seedless cubed watermelon, frozen in little chunks. And after like a long, hot run or bike ride, I'll put those chunks in a blender with some water, maybe a pinch of salt, and blend that up into like a, almost kind of like a slushy or a, what do you call it? A Slurpee, that's the brand name. Yeah, something kind of like that texture, but it's just watermelon and water. And that's so insanely good on a hot day. And that's easy to get many pounds. It's not a problem to get a fair amount of that. So citrulline seems to help because of its role on nitric oxide. And this is one of the ways the body regulates oxygen delivery and vascular health. So when we're able to better synthesize nitric oxide, we can do a better job moving oxygen throughout our whole system and also having a lower tendency towards higher blood pressure and poor cardiovascular output. Citrulline also has some key roles to play in the urea cycle. That means it helps our body get rid of protein byproducts like ammonia more effectively. And it's very central to energy production. There's been some good research about its use in supplement forms and their effects upon energy. We know that athletes can see their function improve. They can perform better without more effort and without more strain. We also know that it can benefit metabolic rate. So older adults using citrulline have been shown to have a higher rate of resting metabolism and burn fat more effectively. So exercise is like the secret sauce, but some comparative studies show that citrulline could do more than high intensity interval workouts. Best thing is both, of course, good exercise and helpful micronutrients. So how do you raise that? Well, you throw some watermelon in your diet. And that's something you can't do a lot of it all the time every day, just boredom and variety. Other food sources, there are many, but not in amounts that are probably relevant. That's why I included that in adrenal energy. So it in that blend has been shown to lower inflammation, reduce some of the normal metabolic wastes, benefit ATP production, help mitochondria work better, improve stored energy and glycogen, lower the pro-inflammatory cytokines, and help tissue oxygenation. So for adults who are not pregnant that want to see better energy output, improve cortisol metabolism as well, adrenal energy is a great blend for that. And one of the star players there is citrulline. 2 capsules once daily with food, and you can get the job done. All right, Dr. C with you. Take great care, and I'll see you real soon. Bye-bye.